one artist with me there in the building, one interview. Also very, very in the sing conscious music, not just any kind of music, now in the sing, you know, instead in the release songs like just twice a year for a specific reason to try pass a message. Now we've been getting them inside the building and we've been following them at some point for one of the roadshow when he's been due. And there's something special with the guy they do where they usually touch me. Every Sunday, in they go around, they like, you know, give food to the less privileged, amazing, which is quite touching. This one, Black Gold, that's what he calls himself, Black Gold. And we get interview with Black Gold. Mona, enjoy this one.
My name is Imperial Augustine, popularly known as by some as Black Gold. Yeah, I'm from Delta State, Sapele precisely, and I do Afropop music and basically echo my sound anti-violence kind of music, conscious music. So I send message with my music. Yeah, I started 5 years ago professionally. I've been doing music, but then I started professionally 5 years ago. It's been tough, and it's not always smooth, but then we're just doing it. Considering the kind of music I do, Nigerians don't vibe to touch music, but we're just trying to, you know, be consistent and so that people will accept the kind of sound I do. Everybody wants to hear the shaku shaku. Like me personally, I love shaku shaku. I vibe to it, but I can't sing it. Not like I can't sing it, but I just feel like my calling is just to, you know, pass a message with my music. It's very difficult to construct. People will always want to do it. I say, get DM, Afan Ablago, do shaku shaku, do trending. But I feel like there's more to music than just, you know, singing. Music is supposed to be a tool to pass a message, not just about dancing and all that. Fine, sometimes I could diversify and, you know, please some certain fans, but still this conscious stuff because I feel like I pass a message with it. That's my own way of, you know, addressing the government, you know, hazards and everything. Yeah, first of all, I'm not a philanthropist, a regular Black Gold music, regular guy. So I just feel like I'm this kind of person. I call myself artist of the masses. So I prefer you call me that. So I don't have the masses at hand like that. So once in a while, not every day, Sundays activities, I go out feeding. You know, it's just something I grew up with my family, just like a way of life. We do that sometimes with my dad would just say, oh, come, let's go feed. So I just kind of, you know, tapped that from my home. So it's not about being a philanthropist or trying to, because I sang a song as regards massive poverty, then using that platform to just, you know, no. It's all about something I grew up, you know, with. It's not news, now. Like you said, there's poverty in the land. You get me? So the country's getting worse and worse. Like I said, my only tools of, you know, addressing and how I feel, how I pass my message is my music. So I felt like the only way I could address the government, like I said, I don't mean no disrespect, but it's a message to the masses and to the government. So I felt like I should just address this because I don't see any reason why, like every as a citizen of a country, you're supposed to be subdued, like entitled to a salary, like minimum 5,000. Let's talk about the disabled ones. Minimum 5,000, like in the USA, different countries. They, you know, they pay them. There's what we call SSN. Like Americans, they pay their disabled citizens. What about the ones that are above 60 years? They give them, you know, a monthly wage. So I just feel like my music should bring awareness to the government, and everyone should coming, and the poverty is getting worse and worse. If we just sit back and just feel like doing, the rich is getting rich and they just feel comfortable, no one voices for the less privileged ones. So I just felt like, you know, I just, this right time to just talk about the poverty, and this music is going to last for, I'm not the kind of artist that sing song every session. I sing song that will last. My music is more like a project. Call it a project because I don't sing regularly. So any song I'm singing, I try to make sure that song is being promoted massively to get to, because it's a message I'm trying to pass with it. So Sam Sudan was the initial plan, and Two Face. It was supposed to be Sam Sudan and Two Face, but along the line, issues came up and all that. So I felt like, okay, yeah, everything happened for a reason. I just sat back and said, it wouldn't make sense if you're just singing and all that. Let's just infuse rap into it. I spoke with my team and we came to a conclusion, okay, fine, let's put a rapper. Which rapper? Apparently, Vector was the only rapper, you know, that came into my mind at that point in time. And of course, most of his rap are always conscious, so I'm not saying other rappers can do, but then I felt like Vector was the perfect match for that song. So my team came up with it and contacted him. That was how it came up. Well, first of all, I would love to commend the music industry with trying, but then I feel like the music industry is too crowded. Every young boy out there wants to sing music, and that's like defiling the name musician. Like sometimes it goes, some guy asks me, I feel like I don't like telling people I'm a musician. If you don't get to know me, then fine, don't ask me. So when I went to the band some days ago, one girl asked me, what do you do, I'm a musician? The girl looked at me, was like, regular Yahoo boys doing the music. And it was really annoying. So I feel like if you don't have the The talent, let me not talk about talent. If you don't have the passion, because apparently 90% of every artist out there now don't have the talent. So if you don't have the passion for music, I don't see you going, why go into music? There are other lucrative businesses you could invest in, like stylist, modeling, different stuff. Why music? You know, gonna those days, like the days of the Rasky Mono, respect. Two-Face, music was respected, music was a profession. You know, but now it's just like a fun stuff. Every young boy wants to go into music, maybe because you're fresh, you're fine, you're cute, you have money, you just feel like, I'm supposed to be a public figure. Man, I want to do music. Man, it's not like that, man. You just have to get the passion. Talent, if you have the talent, that's another advantage, but passion for that. And an encounter with SARS operatives, if you're online, then you'd see it. I did not see, after my old, it was really annoying, but then I did not see any SARS. I said, okay, fine, I won't say, I didn't follow the trend. I said, restructure SARS, because there's some extent we, the youths, we still have our own flops and all that. Though the SARS, they're very annoying, they could overreact and over, you know, their arms, like their arms, they catch them like that. So, but first of all, the youths should coordinate themselves, you know, and the SARS, please. Not every young boy out there, not every young boy, it's cute and hardworking guys out there, young boys, again. There are still, you know, potential youths, you know, hardworking youths out there that does legitimate businesses. So you have to get your facts, you know, interrogate and probably, you know, get your facts right before harassing every youth out there. My songs are project, so it takes like every, I dropped two songs. Like, this is the first song I dropped this year. Last year I dropped Jungle Justice. So I don't just drop songs. I make sure my project gets to the targeted people. So for now, I'm still promoting the video. So I have to wish, before, like in less than like 3 months time, I should be dropping another song. But for now, I'm not thinking of dropping any song right now because I'm trying to pass a message. So it's not about dropping the music, it's about dropping the good content, the right content, and getting to the targeted audience. Keep supporting good music, man. Keep supporting the brand. It's not about the regular Shaku Shaku thing, man. It's fine. Sometimes you vibe to Shaku Shaku, vibe to, you know, danceable songs. But, you know, good music would stay. Conscious music would stay to last long. And I believe my music is a tool to pass a message. So thank you all for supporting the music. Keep supporting the music. We keep doing good music. We're not going to stop.
To enjoy more of this our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.